Hey guys, it's Kelly, welcome back. Today I'm gonna be talking about some boring eyeshadow palettes. So last week I actually did a video, or maybe it was 2 weeks ago, I actually did a video all about eyeshadow palettes that inspire me, get my creative juices flowing, palettes that I would basically never get bored of, I could use over and over again, and constantly come out with new color combinations and new unique looks. Well, after I posted that video, it got me thinking, what about the palettes that are the opposite? What about the palettes that do not inspire me, that are kind of just one-trick ponies? They're fine if I'm going for a certain look, but if I'm sitting down feeling very inspired and want to be creative, these are not the palettes that I reach for. So I do want to make the distinction. I don't think any of these palettes are bad. I actually enjoy the quality of all of these, and when I am going for a specific look, I do like these palettes. Like, I have days when I'm like, I'm feeling that eye look, that's the palette I'm going to use. But overall, when I'm wanting to be creative, these are not the palettes I'm reaching for. So let's start off actually with the palette that I'm wearing today. So I'm wearing a couple different palettes today, but the majority of my eye look was created with the Tartelette Toasted palette. And the reason for that, this is actually the palette in my Flashback Friday this month. And I filmed this video, or I filmed that video right before this one. So I did my makeup for that one and I shared kind of a demo of how I got this eye look. But after I filmed that, I was like, you know, I kind of want to spice up this look a little bit more. So I did reach into my Masquerade palette and use the green on my lower lash line. And then I used a blue eyeliner from Koki on the waterline, if you're wondering. But anyways, all that behind us, the Toasted palette. This was a palette that I was excited to get when it first released because for some reason I looked at it and thought to myself, okay, I have plenty of neutral eyeshadows, but for some reason this palette, this one's gonna be different. This one's gonna be like the ultimate neutrals palette. And it's really not, it's just another neutrals eyeshadow palette. And does it do anything else besides some of the other neutral palettes I'm gonna mention? No, it's a nice warm tone palette that's pretty for the fall season, but is it revolutionary? Does it inspire me? Does it make me wanna try new looks? No. This one really is like the ultimate one-trick pony, and I'm probably gonna use that phrase a lot today or in this video, but I feel like no matter what I do, even when I try to reach into other shades and try to come up with other looks, they pretty much all just look like this, and I'm not mad about it. I don't dislike this look, except for I really struggled to blend out here because these darker shades give me some trouble, but that could fall back on my own makeup abilities. I'm not gonna totally blame the palette, but I like the looks I come up with this palette, but they're nothing revolutionary. Next, let's talk about an old favorite. This is the Nude Tude palette by The Balm. This used to be such a favorite palette for me. This was my go-to palette for every single day. And honestly, I think that's kind of a good use for it. It makes a nice everyday palette. Is the shadow quality the best in the world? No, but for the price tag, it's not bad. And you can create some really nice neutral looks with this. But if you're really trying to get out of the box, do something fun, get out of your comfort zone, you're probably not gonna find that with this palette. And I actually tried panning this last year. It was my Pan That palette for my Project Pan in 2017. And if you guys kept up with that, you know that I struggled finding creativity with this palette. I just felt bored with it throughout most of the year, and it really was difficult for me to reach into it, even though I did successfully make 3 new pans in it. But overall, it's just one of those palettes that it's nice for an everyday look, but you're not gonna get a look that's that different from another palette. Like, whether I, honestly, any of these 5 palettes that I'm gonna mention, I could pretty much come up with the same look in all of them. They're just all so similar and just very standard. The next one is this little guy. This is the Naked Petite Heat from Urban Decay. So with this palette, I can't totally blame the palette. It has 5 shades, 6 shades. So the possibilities aren't necessarily endless, and it is all matte with the exception of this demi matte shade. So for me, this is really a complementary palette that I like to reach for if I am using some other shades. It can be used to create full eye looks, and I have created full eye looks with this. But this palette is nothing revolutionary. I reviewed it and compared it to a lot of other palettes and let you guys know that even though the quality of this is amazing, I won't say amazing, but it's very good quality, a lot of these colors are in other palettes, and I don't look at this and just see like, oh, there's so many eye looks I could do. Yes, this orange right here is pretty inspiring and unique, but once you cover that up, this is pretty standard. So I'm not gonna lie, Unless I'm going for just something very simple and matte, or if I'm reaching for this to pair with something else, this palette's kind of boring to me. Sticking in that matte theme, the new Too Faced Natural Matte Palette is also a little bit boring to me, and I'm not gonna act like I don't like any of these palettes, because I do, and with this one especially, I've created some looks that I really love. I like doing kind of a matte shade in the crease and kind of just a lighter lid, and then a really pretty winged out liner. You could do smoky eyeliner with this. So there are possibilities, but can I get a ton of looks out of this palette that I couldn't get from my other palettes? No. Do I look at this and just see endless possibilities? No. So this one, again, a little bit on the boring side. And the final palette to mention is the Naked 2 from Urban Decay. This is an oldie, but a goodie. This was another complete favorite of mine. You can see how many of these shades have pan or at least significant dips in them. Like, I've for sure gotten my money's worth out of this. And at the time that I got this, my makeup preference was, I like to do the same look every day. I wanted to kind of stick within these tones. I do like the way these cool tones flatter my eyes, so I liked this. But now when I'm wanting to have fun with my makeup, this is the last palette I'm gonna be reaching for. It's fine and the shimmers are like a nice touch. I mean, I like it, but it doesn't get me excited. It makes sense to me why Urban Decay has the Naked line, and of course this palette came out years ago before eyeshadow trends were what they are today. And I feel like it balances out their line because they do have some more colorful palettes with the Vice palettes and also different colorful eyeliners. And this is just kind of your neutral go-to palette, but does it get me excited? Not really. I actually find the Naked 1 to be a little bit more inspiring, still semi-boring, but I like the more neutral tones in that one as opposed to the tones in this one. So that's just personal preference. But that's gonna go ahead and complete this video. I really want to clarify, I'm not saying that you're boring if you use these palettes, that these brands are boring for having these palettes. I don't want this video to be misinterpreted because, as I said, I do enjoy these palettes. They're great quality and they're ones that I do reach for occasionally. But when I'm wanting to have fun and be creative with my palettes, they're just not the ones I go to for that look. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. If you are interested in seeing the eyeshadow palettes that I do reach for when I want to be creative and have fun with my makeup, I will leave the original video linked down below. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this, give it a thumbs up. And let me know your boring palettes in the comment section down below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.